When I looked at the figures from the National Wader censuses, when they started doing the censuses about 30 years ago, they would normally count about 1,000 Pacific Golden Plover a year. Now we're lucky to get 200.
You know, where we used to get hundreds, now we're getting sort of dozens in some sites, which is an indication that there's a population decline.
So obviously there's been a huge decline. Why has that happened? We don't know.
We know virtually zero about them. We don't know where they come from. We don't know how they get here. We don't know how they get back to where they breed. So there's a lot of questions to answer.
Our experience with other species, such as the godwits and knots, is that the population declines mainly occur on the flyway, on the route they take from their home to where we are. So the first thing in order to try and protect them is to find out what route they take so we can then go and explore where the problems might be occurring. What we're going to do is try and catch 10 Pacific Golden Plover and fit them with the new small satellite tags which will track where they go. That will happen in February, and then in sort of March, April, when they start flying back home, we'll be able to track them by satellite and see what route they take and where they end up. Well, they are very difficult birds to catch. We actually had a bit of a practice go last year and caught none, so that showed us that it's not going to be too easy. If we find that at sunset they go to a particular roost, we can put mist nets up so they'll fly in and get caught in the nets, and then we take them out and put them with the transmitters. The other is if they're roosting in a particular, consistently in a particular area of dry land, we can put a net alongside them and fire a cannon net and fire it over the top of them and catch them that way. But for all of that to work, we need to know where they're going to be in different circumstances. And so we have a team headed by Jojo Doyle. She's leading this project, and she's recording where she and various other observers see the birds, but also recording what the state of the tide is, what the weather is like, what the wind direction is, and that sort of thing. So we can reasonably try to predict where in certain circumstances the birds may go.
They were sort of doing this swoop, kind of coming in from further south.
Yeah, I saw that before too. How many were there?
I didn't count them all, but at least 30.
Okay.
So I was so busy with my binoculars trying to figure out if it was them that I sort of, roughly 30, probably more like 40.
So the important thing with that, number one is the time of day, how it relates to the high tide, and then the flight path in or out. So you saw them come in, and we've actually seen them before come in from that direction, flying over the Saka cornea.
And they're coming in for a landing. The far end of sea,
as they're coming into this area to use it. And that's important information for the cannon netters and mist netters to know. It's their decision, but we can offer them the data about what we've seen, what time of day, maybe to help them decide when to put up their mist nets, when this area is being used by the Pacific Golden Plover, and the flight path in. So the flight path in, that is one habitual thing we've been noticing, is that they are coming in over that low Saka cornea and shrub area, which maybe means they would be putting some mist nets over there, possibly.
We have to go through a very strict process. I mean, to catch and band birds at all in New Zealand, you need to have qualifications, and you've got to have been get a permit from the Department of Conservation, and they're not given out lightly. So there's a lot of work has to go into convincing the authorities that we're doing it the best possible way and with the least possible risk to the birds.
One thing about this project already is that in trying to monitor them to find out where they're doing, to try and get to the stage of predicting where they might be so we can catch them, we're already learning a lot about them. You know, it's quite interesting, and just in a few short weeks we're learning a lot more than we used to, because we're paying more attention to them. Actually, in the past, there were golden plovers in the background, but now they're front and centre. So that's been a big change.
I mean, when I started this, I must admit, when you think you've got to raise $25,000, we've got to get all the permits, and I've never done anything like this before. We need to get all the top people together, the top birders, the top experts on Pacific Golden Plover, and it seems like mission impossible. But actually, it's fallen into shape amazingly well. I think because there's so much goodwill around New Zealand and the world for protecting birds like these. So it's really exciting to me to see it actually taking shape, and in about 3 months' time, I think it will happen.